Welcome to the second part of the topic protection methods. Today we will look at some schemes used for microgrid protection. We will see some of the protection methods that provide high selectivity and learn about the role of communication in microgrid protection. Differential protection is usually used to protect important machines or equipment. This method has the highest selectivity among the protection schemes as it protects any equipment during an internal fault. The equipment could be a transformer, a distribution or transmission line, etc. This method consists of comparing the input and output current of the equipment. During normal operation, the difference between the two values is very low, which is due to the internal power losses in the equipment. When a fault occurs, however, the difference between the input and output currents is high and causes the relay in the equipment to trip and disconnect the equipment from the grid. Although this protection method has high selectivity, it relies on the communication network to transmit the measured currents to the control logic. As the communication network is also subject to failures, a backup protection is usually needed in addition to the differential protection, causing a great increase in the cost of this method. In microgrids, the faulty current can be generated from different sources and can be in more than one direction. This leads to the use of directional overcurrent units, usually to determine the faulty feeders, which usually feed several distribution generators. The exclusive use of non-directional relays leads to possible faulty or maloperation. Using directional units leads to activation of the feeder protective relay only, keeping the other devices or relays at backup. Let's review again the time current tripping curve of an overcurrent relay that we have already seen when talking about the speed protection criteria. The characteristic consists of three parts. The L part, which occurs during overload conditions, where the current might reach from one up to two times the rated value. Typically, the transformers and lines are not able to sustain such large overcurrent for a long period of time, causing the overcurrent relay to disconnect within several seconds or minutes. The S part, which occurs during short circuits. When the fault occurs, the level of current dramatically increases. In such cases, the relay is expected to disconnect within a very short time, around 300 milliseconds. Finally, the I part, or the instantaneous part, is activated when the current of the relay has a very high value, during lightnings, for example. Protection schemes are generally divided into two groups, with and without communication. The no communication scheme, the time current tripping curve of the relays in the microgrid, is set based on the local information. The selectivity in this scheme is low, since the decisions are based on the local information instead of the whole microgrid. The advantage of such protection scheme is the lower cost, as the computational and ICT costs are not in place. On the other hand, if a communication infrastructure is implemented, the settings of the relays can be adjusted, taking into account several factors, such as the configuration of the network and the type and location of the distributed generators. This scheme can be implemented in either a centralized or decentralized way. The figure shows the decentralized scheme based on a wide area measurement. Naturally, the schemes are more selective but less reliable, due to the dependence on the ICT and resulting in the need for backup protection. This also increases computational and total costs of the scheme. Finally, we will discuss adaptive protection. Adaptive protection is a protection scheme that adjusts its protective response based on the network and system operating conditions. This selective response relies on the intervention of the microgrid's control system. To increase the reliability of the protection, adaptive schemes have been introduced such that the relay settings are adjusted based on their operation conditions. Most adaptive methods have the following characteristics. First, a central unit for continuous monitoring of the operational parameters of the system. Second, an algorithm developed in the central unit to analyze the structure of the network and to calculate new protection settings based on the current operating conditions. However, Due to the communication requirements, adaptive methods are normally more expensive than other methods. Additionally, it is necessary to update the coordination algorithm following significant changes in the system, like the addition of a new transmission line or a feeder. Let's now wrap up. We evaluated various protection schemes in microgrids. We saw how communication increases the selectivity of the protection method, such as differential protection, communication-based, and adaptive protection methods. The reliance on the communication network, however, makes the protection system less dependable, needing a backup protection system and increasing the overall cost of the system.